Hello, Bobby McSquiggums here, and it's time to continue with my Let's Play of Massive Chalice. This is episode 13, and it is time to continue. Well, unfortunately, I had this all set up for Twitch, and I got about 10 minutes in and realized I was streaming and not recording. So, problematic, but it's fine. We shall continue! And it looks like our people are all going to die off, but there's a relic at the age of 64. That's super nice, and I figured out that it has been a terrible, awful atrocity against nature. Let's see here. Clumsy, hardy, quick study versus asthmatic. I think I'm going to give it to the female at age 3. I'm going to roll out with that. And yeah. Oh, and we have to appoint a new regent. I think I'm going to go with the male suitor. All right. And let's see, there are females abound everywhere. An 11 and a 17-year-old, average fertility. Not great, not terrible. We're going to roll with that. That's fine. 11 to 17, not that big of a gap. They will start having children eventually. Alright, so that has happened. There's going to be more deaths coming up soon, since I know what the first 7-8 minutes or so actually holds. I hate this group of people because they're all infertile. Even though he died at like a ridiculously old age, all of them are infertile, so it really doesn't make any difference. None of them are truly amazing anyway. So it literally has no, just no point. Hold on. We're gonna go with the eldest. Hopefully they'll die off sooner than later. Maybe we can kill off some more. We're gonna send Megan into the deal. There we go. And no, you do not get a partner because you cannot have babies. And you do not get to feel the warmth of another body because you're infertile. It's shameful, I know. Alright, the age of 62, and then yet another one has died. However, first we get to pass on the spine. And we are probably going to end up passing that on to, I believe I went with Jaina. She's only age 3, but she's decent. And she's infertile, so she can't be used as a figurehead. And we have to appoint a new regent. I went with Renfield. And I had to go with Carol Everhart because everybody else is infertile. So we are slowly breeding our people to death. It's not pleasant. It's not great. But it simply is what it is. Oh.
Work is never done.
And we
wouldn't
have,
bring it up if it wasn't important.
And apparently we have a different random event than last time. So let's see here. The Wanderer with a thundering boom, the great doors of the throne room are thrown open and clearly inebriated woman stumbles in. She shouts as she makes her way up to you. Though she loses her way several times and has to re-enter the room twice, finally she reaches your throne and leans in close to you.
Please give Tessa the relic owned by Laura Norton Blackwell, please.
Yeah, that's probably not gonna happen. Who's Tessa? Apologize and tell her that unfortunately no relics can be spared at the moment. Send for the doctors. It's clear that she needs some kind of medical attention. Let's view the heroes. Let's see who Tessa is. If she's a Blackwell baby, maybe, because, Alora's getting kind of high up in the age there. She is a Vanguard, though. I don't see a Tessa anywhere. So I gotta say, I don't know who Tessa is. It's not looking great. No Tessas. Standards? Nope, there's not a single Tessa. So I'm gonna have to say emphatically no. Okay. So we sent for the doctors, unsurprised. She barely acknowledges the doctors heading toward her. Ah, we shipping off already? Then onward! As they help her to the medical ward, she reaches under her cloak and pulls out a relic.
Just wanted a couple of souvenirs. Don't think I'll be needing this anymore.
She places on the floor with a wink and quickly rejoins the doctors, leaving you in a state of pure bewilderment. Alora Norton Blackwell has gained the Relic Whistler. Huh. Okay, but she already has a relic. How does she have two relics? What does that even mean? And what kind of connotation does that have for our people in the future? How does one person control two relics? Let's take a look. I mean, we're gonna have to look at the items, I guess. She's using the Resonator, but she's also got the Whistler. The Resonator does 12 to 21 damage. It's pretty significant. This one does absolute garbage. But we can level it up a little bit quicker. This one's already hitting pretty hard, and I feel as though using it, you know, obviously leveling it up more might be benef- official, or perhaps it's max level, because it says 6,000 to 6,000. Maybe that is the max level it can hit, so I think I am going to swap weapons. It's unfortunate that I can't pass it on to someone else, but that's okay. That is okay. Alright, so that is fine, and we are going to continue. We're about halfway through the 300 Years' War, assuming that is correct. It's time to give the Cadence a taste of their own medicine, because the Bone Barb bows are finished. What? Alright, so we now have piercing shots. And that is sweet, sweet nice. But again, that's on non-relic things, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. Alright, so stuff is starting to get pretty expensive here. Unstable carapace armor. What is this? Ruptures love catching assailants off guard by detonating themselves. Okay. That doesn't seem like a good idea. Ruptures love, we could do them one better by outfitting our alchemists with volatile armor that triggers when they take damage at all. Or we can go with the bone shell armor, which is good for the caberjacks, but temporary tough shell, you know what, I think that might be a decent thing. And that will prevent them from taking any additional damage. Let's take a look at the weapons. The Time Fist. A caber in the right hands can be, or can already induce hour-long blackouts. But what could it? What if it could knock enemies into next week or later? With some harvested Twitcher arms, this nightmare could become reality. Or the Pillar Pitcher, inspired by the Cradle's ability to quickly create seeds on the battlefield, we could build new throwers for the alchemists that would generate pillars in an instant. Great for offense and defense. Sorry guys, I'm struggling with reading today. The window's open and the wind is blowing and it's kind of distracting. The dog is doing things down by my feet and I'm just terrible in general. So oops, no, we need to actually go back and do some research. That is unacceptable. Alright, I think we need to research. Do we have a nation one? Nope. We need to recruit some new heroes because we have very, very, very bad bloodlines at this point. So we need to recoup a little bit of that. Alright, there's babies being born and an attack. And this time, I think we're just going to go here right away. It's the one that has a 1. I don't really care about the rewards at this point. We just need to get it handled. Alright, so she is set. We can add a hero. Let's see what you, Blackwell, has to offer. Asthmatic, slow learner, and attuned. Not great. Nikon. Dim-witted, slow learner. Jeez. Oh, Blackwells are definitely not looking good. What about you, Trevor? Oh, you're not super great either. Good, sir. Alright, well, these guys are level 4, so, I mean, we're just going to have to deal with it. They're kind of set up for lifelong, Their bloodline is completely toast. If we had another Caberjack group, I would use them, but we don't, so... well, crap, what about Eleazar? Pessimistic, reckless? I can handle that. Yeah, you're definitely coming along, buddy. Welcome to the team. We have no alchemist at this point? No, we do not. Jennifer and Fabino, you need to return to us. You're okay. We'll have you join the squad. I think that's sweet, sweet nice. We gotta get you outfitted correctly. You hooked up with the spirit, some veil armor, and of course the ultra elixir for a good measure. Now let's make sure you are set too. I don't think you are. We need to unlock your ability here. Oh, and we're gonna put it down. You know what? We'll have honed hearing with you. Excuse me. Let's see here. Equipment. You. Ooh, the bone barb bow. All right. So you're not gonna have a special weapon, but you can have that. There we go, and the Ultra Elixir, and it's sweet, sweet nice. So there we go. Ooh, that thing looks crazy sick. Alright, and I guess we're going to use a Caber Jacker just because. Sure, why not? Eliza, why don't you come join us? The Ram Cap Caber. Better armor. I mean, maybe we can sacrifice you. In fact, I'm thinking that we might want to, just to get rid of your bloodline in general. Because, I mean, offense is probably going to be taken, and it probably should be, but you guys are worthless, and I don't want you around anymore. So we're going to try very, very hard to get you out of our little compartment of death and destruction here. And one additional thing, we need to unlock some skills with you. And we're going to put it down. And with that, we're going to go with the 4 shooty-pew guys. And we're going to go with one of the Caberjackers, who is infertile. and so is the entire family line. So any relics that are found or made is going to be kind of a down spiral for us because... Ooh. Well, because it's not actually going to be passed on. So that is not great. Alright, I'm going to take a shot and miss. Fantastic. That is, of course, exactly what I was hoping for. Not even sort of. Alright, we're going to take a double shot. Pierce right through. And the Wrinkler is... Well, he's not really pushing up daisies, but it's definitely not having a great time. Might do enough damage to finish this. Let's see. We did, and we knocked back the other one and did tremendous damage to him, too. And stunned him. I mean, that was actually impressive. I really wish our Caberjack people were a little bit more powerful. Let's see, what kind of damage did we do? Oh, we do plenty. We hit, we kill. There we go. That is sweet, sweet nice. We have a lapse way off in the distance. And I think if we go stealth mode and we go over here and do some exploring, we'll see there's even more lapses waiting for their time to shine and their time to die. So let's see if they come toward us or what they do. They may just go on a little patrol area around their little slice of heaven or wherever they are right now. It's fine. It's fine and it's sweet, sweet nice. Alright, so that's all well and good. We've crushed them. There's not much more for us to do. I think we're going to explore this way just to see what enemy is actually over here. Alright, we have a wither and we have a lapse and we have a cradle. So, oh, another wither that I missed. So that's not bad. That's going to be a nasty little place to deal with. Let's go over here. Let's get our Blackwell person into a position. I think I'm going to move probably deeper in. Maybe get on this side or something down here and shoot from that angle. No, I don't want to confirm that move. I think I'm going to go exploring with Jennifer and Fimbino over this way. Nothing of any importance anyway. Imagine if I explore that direction, it's probably not going to be the greatest for me. So what I'm going to do instead is kind of just move him maybe here. It's actually probably a her. I don't remember what name which one we chose, but... Uh-oh. That's not good. Oh, that's pretty good, though. Go for the evasion, ladies and gentlemen. Go for evasion. Alright, looks like we're going to have to take out some lapses in this next turn here. Oh, that's pretty close. The Wrinkler's coming up on him. Oh, and that one's actually wanting to fight, and the Cradle didn't seem to care, so... Alright, so we have ourselves a little bit of an issue at this point. So let's see if we can solve our problems in a respectable manner. I'm thinking probably not. So what my plan's going to be is the Wrinkler is going to cause us a lot of issues, especially if he can close with us. So I'm kind of leaning toward wanting to murder his soul first. So I think I'm going to move here and we'll take a look, see if we can actually land a nice shot. I don't think it's going to be enough. You know, we have a Flaro. Why don't we launch the Flaro up? That blinded everyone, including our own person, but we can back our person up at this point. Our Caberjack guy is over there. They both moved. Let's see if we can get our Caberjack person over this way. And that's an interesting position to be in, but I don't think it's overwhelmingly bad. Now, the enemy saw us, which isn't great, but they're both blinded, and so is the other one. This one's going to shoot, probably hit. 150 experience, we'll regain that, no problem. I mean, it is Alora Butter Blackwell, so... Or Alora Butter Norton Blackwell? I don't know. Something crazy like that. Alright, so it looks like the blinding is pretty much done skis. Let's see... Oh, that will actually hit both, huh? Right, I'm going to move here. And I'm going to hopefully take my shot. Looks like I get two. Oh, I hit my own person. Oh, I'm actually kind of glad that the second shot missed. Holy crap. Didn't know I would hit my own person in that. That kind of sucked. Alright, so, we've learned something new, ladies and gentlemen. We've learned something new. Alright, let's see if we can take this one out. Nope. Things just don't seem to work well for my people. Alright. What kind of shot do we have? Not the best. Oh my gosh. I'm missing everything, huh? Alright, let's see if we can get our caberjack guy over here to just crush this one. Boom!
And good riddance, you deplorable beast of pestilence!
Okay, that's not so bad. Gonna step back. And going to take a shot, and it should hit. And it does. And we put it down. Alright, so it's their turn to shine now. Okay, that exploded. I'm hoping that that thing doesn't close with us. Oh, yay. More experience down from our people who are unable and incapable of actually hitting anything of any consequence. It's quite unfortunate and, well, more than a little sad. Oh, going the back way. Just hoping to avoid that. Okay, so at this point, I'm going to move here. Going to take a shot. Probably going to miss. Oh, we actually landed that. I'm okay with that. Alright, how close are we? We are not very close at all. Doesn't look like we can go through that either. I'm going to try to taunt the thing, since we have that ability. Prime target. How's that not working? Oh, okay, hold on. All visible enemies taunted into attacking, so this has been an update. So they changed how that worked out. So that's actually pretty nice, then. That used to be a solo target skill, and now it's a multi-target skill. I like that. I like that a lot. Alright, Alora's going to back up here a little, and we're going to hopefully hit and confirm our... Ooh, we missed. That's not great. Let's see, what can we do with you? Move you over here. Probably hit you with a shot. Oh, not bad. There we go. So the wrinklers are going to have to come at us, and they shouldn't be able to close with anyone. Oh, yeah, I was wrong. Not that really worried. Eh. Stunned off the rebound, that's fine. Should have killed it with somebody else, considering that's kind of my plan, is to utilize other people to do these things. I'm going to use our stealthing abilities over here to get ourselves into hopefully better positions. There's no way to be sure whether or not it will work, but we can certainly try it. We'll move here, and that's going to be it. So, enemy, do your worst, or just sit there and don't really do anything. I'm okay with both of those. Alright, we're going to sneak over here. Going to sneak over here. Going to sneak way over here, as long as you're not seen. Okay. And I think we are more or less set. Can we move there? There we go. Alright. Getting into position down here with our other person, and I don't know, maybe send our caberjack person right there, and we'll end our turn, and hopefully nothing bad happens. Labs is sitting there, the wrinklers are sitting there. Oh, one moved out. Well, that's unfortunate. Oh, he's going on the aging attack. That's okay. I don't hate that. Not sure how he knew we were there, though. That's somewhat problematic, I suppose. Alright, so what are we looking at here? Alright, we're going to take a shot at the cradle. Did a little bit of work with the cradle. That's fine. We're going to move a little closer and follow up attack. It's not going to be quite enough, but it's something. We put a little bit of fear and hatred into the cradle there. Alright, we have a couple options now available to us. I think what I'm going to do is this one. And the follow-up hit, not enough. And then I'm gonna move here, and I think I'm going to shoot. Doesn't look like I can hit both, unfortunately. Alright, well, we're gonna hit this one. And second shot follow-up hits, and success. Alright, so that worked out, I guess. And then our caberjacker's gonna go and, well, do battle. It's fine, looks like that lapse is gonna be able to get a shot off. It missed, thankfully. Gotta love those evasive armor sets that we have. The wrinkler's gonna come and age our person a little bit more. 5 age gained, that's okay. Again, we don't care, the caberjacker can die. Oh, we miss, and the seed is now born, and I am okay with that. It is sweet, sweet nice. It's fine. It's wonderful. In fact, it's free experience if we can land the attack, and it looks like we did. Excellent. And I believe Alora is going to level up this weapon by slaughtering the cradle. And that leaves the lapse as our target here with the remaining two. 17 to 22, and that was indeed enough. Alright, up next we have Eleazar coming up here to do a little bit of damage at range. And bam! Pretty nice maneuvers, I like it. And that leaves Captain Caberjack himself, and we said good day, sir.
Good riddance, you deplorable beast of pestilence!
So there we go. That means this wrinkler should try to close with us, but apparently that was not in the card, so we're going to go get ourselves a flanking position in stealth. Looks like we've cleared out everything else. There may be something back by the entrance to this place, but I doubt it. Move there, going to stealth our way over here. And there may still be somebody up in that corner, though I also doubt it. Gonna move over here. And finally, we're having little issues there with moving. There we go. Your move, sir. Your move. Alright, trying to find our person. Trying to close with it. It's not going to work. We're going to go and try to annihilate this person in one fell swoop. And we said good day, sir. Boom goes the dead guy. Victory? Yes, no, maybe? No, we are not victorious yet, ladies and gentlemen. Something is still lurking in the distance. There is still an enemy hidden within. So my only guess as to where this enemy may or may not be... Oh! Okay, that's actually not where I thought... Well, I thought it was in this general region, but I thought it was actually back here. So that's kind of good to know, that we actually found the enemy we were searching fervently for. Or frantically. Yeah, frantically, it's a different term, but it still works. Fervently implies dedication and such. Frantically just means like a panicked search. Which, you know, I suppose we're sort of panicked. Well, I was hoping our caberjack guy would actually die off. It's kind of unfortunate that he didn't. Or she didn't. Eliza is actually doing work. It's kind of disheartening. Just crushing souls. Looks like she even leveled up. We're going to hopefully lose some of that experience from our next enemy that we kill. But who can say? Who can say? I think I'm going to move here. The lapse is going to move over. Is the lapse going to attack? The lapse is not going to attack. However, we are going to miss. Because we're amazing like that. Laura, where are you at? What if you move here? Do you have a shot? You should have a shot. You have a shot. If you hit, you kill. And that might be the end. Victory? Victory! Alright, so massive victory.
For every pawn killed today, I want a roasted turkey waiting for that hero.
Yeah.
Shutting the door on vegetarians again, huh? Aww. You always forget about the vegetarians.
Oh, excuse me, yes. Sorted salads as well, please.
Yeah, I like turkey. Definitely not a vegetarian. Alright, so overall 52116. That's to be expected, and hopefully that's some good levels up on that relic. And we are gaining in levels with our people that are being popped out and born and such, but I don't know, guys. Our tactical team has rescued a baby boy who shall be trained at a stronghold. We're going to adopt it to the Blackwell name, I think. Where are the Blackwells? There they are. And hopefully this child is decent. Delgoon. Alright, nimble. That's good. That is good. Alright. Hopefully the Blackwells make good parents. And we are going to continue onward. Hopefully when this new recruits come up, it's going to be sweet, sweet nice.
Is half what it needs to be to cleanse all this right. world of the Cadence. So this calls for the Horns of Halves.
Every time
Don't
the horn sounds the same.
Don't let this get to your head. We still have a long way to go. And it's not going to get easier.
Too many battles have been lost because victory was assumed and not assured.
Uh-huh. All right. So there we go, folks. We have hit the halfway mark. Year 150. Well, technically 151, and we're getting pretty close to, well, like I said, we're at the halfway mark. We're getting to go down the downslope of things. From the future episodes on, it will be all downhill from there. It's fine. Either way, guys, that's going to do it for this episode. I will see you tomorrow with more Massive Chalice. Until then, my name is Bumpy McSquiggums, and I will see you later.